Hey, you.
Who, me?
Yeah, you.
Dad?
Want to learn how to deal with a fire?
Yeah.
Want to learn how to keep your home safe from a fire?
Uh-huh.
Well then, how to be safe. Be fire safe. It's perfect for you.
Okay. Hello, my name is Super Cool Amazing, Gear King the Boss Parker.
Hello, my name is Alex.
First step of being fire safe is to make sure that your smoke alarms are working properly. If it starts to flash red every 45 seconds, that indicates the alarm is working. If it is chirping every minute, that means the battery needs to be replaced. Again, make sure that your smoke detector's battery is checked once every month.
Again?
Hello, today I will be replacing a smoke detector battery. This is how you do it. The three required things you will need is a smoke detector, a battery, and a battery checker. This is how you check the battery. So make sure you put the battery onto these two holes right here. And then if it says good, it will go in the green. And if it's good, you can use it. And if it's in bad, if it's in replace, you should never use it. And this one was good, so I could use it. This is how you put it in. Make sure you put positive, negative. Negative always go towards the back. And then make sure you click it again, and bring it up to where you have the holder, and then make sure you put it in. Great job. The second step to being fire safe is planning two escape routes in every room of the house. Mostly, they will be either doors or windows. Make sure that the doors and windows are not blocked. I have planned escape routes for this floor, as you can see. Each room has two escape routes. Go over your family with your family at least once a month to figure out where
they are. Step to being fire safe is to make sure that your ovens are always turned off when they're not in use. Because if they're on, that could cause a fire when you least expect it, and also it could cause a burn to someone. And also, pot handles, they can't be like this. They have to be to the side because little kids could come by and grab it and could accidentally tip over all the hot stuff onto them. And also, make sure inside your kitchens to have a smoke detector in your kitchen somewhere just in case of a fire. And also, make sure you have a dry-based fire extinguisher, but if it's water-based, for grease fires, you use
flour. Step to being fire safe is knowing how to correctly use matches, select things like barbecues. First, I will need a box of matches.
Whoa, where'd you get those?
Four.
You need to put those high up so little kids can't get them, like here.
Where?
Like put them up here above the fridge so little kids can't grab them.
Oh,
so,
I see.
Yeah. Okay, let's go outside and light it.
Alright.
Okay, Alex, this is how you start a propane grill. So you make sure this is on all the way. And then you turn this on between high and low. And then you light the match and drop it in. And then you can turn it up to high, and then you're done. Step of being fire safe is knowing how to use a fire extinguisher and knowing when to use it. A fire extinguisher is good for putting out all types of fire. For example, let's say this socket right here is burst into flames. Would I throw water on it? No, I would use a fire extinguisher. Fire extinguisher would put it out safely. Here is how you use it. First, you stand about 6 feet away from the fire, and then you put it down and spray it. This is the final step of being fire safe. If you're on fire, your body will want to think, hey, run around like a crazy psycho, like this little kid.
Oh my gosh, I'm on fire! Oh my gosh, what do I do? Oh my, no, no, no! Oh my, no! I'm gonna die now! No!
First, stop running, drop and roll on the ground, like this. That's how you do it.
If you follow all these steps, it should look a little something like this.
Everywhere you'd think me rude, but I would just stand.